We're trying to make an impact in people's lives, and I wish we can at the end of the day. And if that happens, that's what I would see as the legacy. I don't see an impact in a broader sense. I would like to see an impact on those people.
It's amazing how 22 million people can live in this city, and the city extends itself. The people are really the ones that are planning. People invade spaces and create new areas, and then the government arrives with the infrastructure instead of being the other way around. So for me, it's also that incredible source of inspiration to understand how society builds itself. And I think this is great for inspiring what I do. I learned architecture manually, and even if I learned to do it digitally, I would go back again to do it manually. I think architecture is about space, so it's very important that we design it within space, no? This is why I believe in the use of models and physical models. I sit and think of the light and how it goes in and how it goes out. If it doesn't work, even though if it's beautiful sculpture, then it's not architecture, it's sculpture, but that's bad design.
Something that characterizes us is that we are used to work with a minimum. So we work really with a lot of constraints. It's making everything that we do very efficient is a principle that we can use everywhere, and it can be translated everywhere. So our studio is not about the form or the shape of the building. It's about what it does to people. For me, that's also allowing a lot of opinions to come in. You know, I'm not going to debate the way of reacting towards beauty or towards aesthetic part of the building, but I'm always going to debate whether that beauty even serves the people that are intended to inhabit this space. The most important part is, for me, the understanding of our roots, the understanding of our capabilities, capacities, and translating that into contemporary architecture. I am very aware of the people that lives in it, that builds it, and that maintains it. So we basically use very raw materials, which is what we have available, part of the local economy. And we understand that it's very good when we are hard labor intensive because people need jobs, but also it's the way here it's done, no? So we try not to replace people for machines. And we take advantage of that. We have very creative, flexible hand labor. So using it, we take that in consideration since the first moment where we're starting design. So I think that's what rooted us to Mexico. In a way, I also think that for me, that's going back to the principles of architecture, of understanding that it's making places and spaces by people for people.